This car from 1960 embodies the advanced design, engineering, and originality that was required for it to become an award-winning design in that year. It was part of a huge competition called the Fisher Body Craftsman Guild Competition. The challenge was to design the car of the future. Each year, for over 40 years, thousands of cars were designed for this challenge. And incredibly enough, for the bulk of those decades, most of the contestants were teenagers. Today, very few people would know what the Fisher Body Craftsman Guild competition was. But in mid-century America, the event was so big and had so many members that it was rivaled in size only by the Boy Scouts of America. Here are some of the features that in that year, 1960, made this car an award-winning car. The passenger compartment is comprised of a twin canopy top with tinted windows and an intercom system that allowed the occupants to communicate with each other. It has a jet-age wedge-shaped design, folding headlights to reduce drag, and an innovative grille that is engineered to go straight through the middle of the car and thereby eliminate the need for air intakes and bulky grills in the front. This, of course, improved overall aerodynamics. I discovered this car when I attended a car show in Pasadena, California, but it was just one of almost 100 other cars just as exciting as this one. And what's so amazing is that many of these had been lost, undocumented, and just plain forgotten. And they might have been forgotten forever, except for the grassroots movement by a historian and a handful of car lovers and collectors who sought to resurrect them once again. So, when I encountered this car, it was surrounded by other equally amazing automobiles that were presented in ascending order by year, and that made for a great visual journey. Starting with the earliest cars, you could see the progress of the automobile's design and technology. You could see a morphing of one decade's vision of the future giving way over time to new ideas and engineering that would be favored by trends in a later decade. So, we can do a brief overview of the changes that occurred over the decades with these cars. If we explore some of the early car designs from the 1940s, we see teardrop shapes and the fascination for new technologies like rear engines, steering-controlled headlights, and the integration of air scoops. New industrial production capabilities like the ability to create curved glass were incorporated into these cars as wraparound windshields. Likewise, bumpers, headlights, grills, and fenders were also merged to form simple, streamlined shapes. 10 years later, as the post-war consumer boom of the 1950s took hold, curvaceous, slightly Europeanized, glamorous boulevard cruisers with long hoods, powerful engines, massive chromework, and two-tone colors reflected the new wealth and taste of the American middle class. Sensibilities changed again, and by the 1960s, cars featured simple, wedge-shaped designs, unconventional wheelbase formats, massive raking windshields, innovative three- and four-wheel chassis, novel cab-forward designs, and cars equipped with electric propulsion. The 60s was perhaps the most fruitful decade for new ideas, but it was also the last decade of the competition. So, that was just a small introduction across the years of these amazing Fisher Body cars. It's easy to see the incredible progress made in those decades. Improved design seemed intrinsic to new engineering and manufacturing capabilities. But there's a lot more to learn about these amazing cars. One of the most incredible facts is that most of these were designed and built by teenagers, some as young as 13 years old. We've only seen a handful of the tens of thousands of cars that were built for this huge annual event. And as you can see, these futuristic cars are eye candy for designers and history buffs to see and enjoy. If you are familiar with the contest, you realize that in my showing these cars, I've used a sleight of hand, which I will reveal in future reports. But it will allow me to highlight the important origins and reasons why the contest was started in the first place. With that in mind, in future reports, I will continue to show more of the cars that were part of this huge competition. And I will also answer some of the most intriguing questions that come to mind. What happened to all the amazing cars, and how did they get forgotten? Are there still lost cars waiting to be discovered? Why haven't you seen these cars at car shows and in museums? And how did this contest begin, and who benefited from it? Well, I will answer all those questions and many more. So stick with me, and you will see a whole lot more of these cars in Carthropology's upcoming reports on the Fisher Body Craftsman Guild.